Hello, my name is Jeanette and welcome to my channel. Today I am taking you sourcing with me for Amazon retail arbitrage. I already know exactly where I want to go first today. I saw a commercial for this item and ever since I saw the commercial, I can't get it out of my head. Once I get it, I feel like I can move on with my life. So let's get it. All right, I'm so excited. I'm weirdly excited. What I saw a commercial for the other day was a Sonic Churro milkshake. That was my motivation to get out of the house and get sourcing today, was because I promised myself this milkshake. Here it is. It's so thick that I cannot suck it up through the straw. Oh, this is a lot of work. Of course it's delicious. I feel like you would need a spoon for this. That's hard on the sucker. Okay, I'm gonna eat this churro out of here while it's still crispy. It's a decent sized churro. Brain freeze. And the guy at Sonic was so nice and so friendly. He told me that these churro milkshakes are very popular right now. And then he asked me if I've tried the pickle slushy. What? I thought he was joking. But he's serious. They have a pickle slushy. Then he said, I will give you a sample for free. Pickle slushy. I got one. Look at it. So cute. It's neon green. Looks like pickle juice. Let's try it. He said this is popular on the TikTok. I try to stay off TikTok because whenever I go on TikTok, when I like get out of it, 3 hours has passed and I don't want to waste my life on TikTok. I do love TikTok, but it's just a trap. It traps me. So anyways, all that to say, I didn't even know this was a thing. All right, so let's try the pickle slushy. Actually, I want to take the lid off. Whoa, this looks like antifreeze. Let's give it a swirl. It literally tastes like drinking pickle juice, like dill pickle juice. It's a little sweet. Ooh. Man, I am not good at drinking cold things. Brain freeze is the worst. This is okay. I wouldn't order this. I'm not a huge fan of the pickle slushy, but it was fun to try. I love trying new things, especially food things. Yeah. Okay. All right. I'm done with this. If I had to choose between a pickle slushy and the churro milkshake, we're getting the milkshake. All right. I got my fix. Let's start sourcing. My first stop is going to be the World Market outlet. Okay, so last time I went here, they didn't really have a lot and I almost left empty-handed. But then at the very last minute, I found this super cool like bar accessory. Great profit. So I figured why not dip back in here and see if there's anything new and fresh. This is one of those stores I like to visit, you know, at least once every couple months. And just see what they have. I've had really good luck with notebooks here, drink mixes. I've had some luck here. There's been some jewels here. Definitely check out the World Market outlet if you got one near you. Done searching in the World Market. So when I went in there, I looked through all of their groceries and I found a few things that were close, but I didn't wind up getting. Make sure you check the dates, like with all groceries, check the date before you scan it. Then I went through like the stationery and the books and stuff, because that's where I've had good luck in the past. Didn't find anything. Then I went over to the household and I got excited for a second because last time I was here, I found this really cool bar gadget that I was telling you about and they had more, a lot more. So I was like, oh, I'm about to buy all these, until I checked my inventory and I realized I have one left and the rank, which used to be really good, is now like through the roof. So I decided not to get them, but I'll keep an eye on it. If the rank so happens to drop again, maybe I'll come back and get some, because I know where they're at. All right, let's see if I can suck this up yet. Better. Next stop is going to be somewhere, I think I've only stopped once before, maybe twice. Never really had any luck, but today I'm feeling like I want to go into places that I haven't been into in a while. So I'm heading to Macy's. I'm hoping that they have some Nike stuff, like Nike shoes, Nike clothes. I also want to check out the house gadgets there. I don't know. Let's just, I'm feeling like I need to go to Macy's today. It's calling me. Hello, is this Macy's? I'll be right there. Okay, I am officially at Macy's. Let's go see what Macy's has to offer. Do you source at Macy's? I've heard of people sourcing at Macy's during Q4. There was some good deals. I mean, as a regular everyday sourcing spot, I don't know. Let's find out. I just got out of Macy's and I had so much fun in there. I had more fun than I expected I would. My plan of action when I got in there was to just to do the outer ring of the store and then maybe, you know, shoot up and down the middle too. So that's what I did. I went through some clothes and scanned some things. Didn't really find anything. Then I went through bras, but I bought bras at Kohl's what feels like forever ago. And I still have like half of them in stock. So I would sell bras again. I'm just not in the mood for it today. Okay. Then I wound up in shoes. And the women's shoes department in Macy's is really nice. So I scanned a lot of their shoes and I was just going up and down every single aisle, scanning every brand because I wanted to see what brands I could sell and which ones I couldn't. For example, they have Michael Kors. That's restricted. Couldn't sell that. But I was noticing that I could sell Easy Spirit. I also could sell a brand called DV Dolce Vita that made like 10 bucks, but it would have been a $65 investment. So I passed on those because if I'm spending $60, that's a lot of my money to be tied up for a while. And when I get it back, I want to make like at least 50%, especially on those bigger items. I mean, I don't always follow that rule for sure, but it's a good guideline to have. But you just do you. Go with your gut. And my gut told me no on these shoes. And I got ungated in a bunch of shoe brands, which I will add to my ungating list. If you've heard me say this before, I'm sorry for repeating myself, but for those of you who don't know, I have a free auto ungating spreadsheet. So every time I get auto ungated in something, I add it to this spreadsheet. And you can try to get auto ungated too, because if you head over to my blog, JeanetteSteele.com, and sign up for my blog, newsletter, whatever you want to call it, you'll get access, free access to my auto ungating spreadsheet. So I will add everything I just got auto ungated in there to this spreadsheet, which includes a brand of shoes called Circus by Sam Edelman. Never heard of it. But I'm auto-ungated now. I will add it to the sheet. I also got auto-ungated in Madden Girl, which I've heard of, and it was for these fabulous sparkly pumps, which I loved. I would have taken these shoes home. I would have rocked those shoes, but I did not get them. But I did get ungated, and I will add that to the list. I also got ungated in a shoe brand called Naturalizer. Never heard of it, but again, they're sparkly. I tend to gravitate towards sparkly shoes. I also got ungated in Deer Stags. Never heard of it, but again, I will get ungated in whatever I can. So scanning a lot of women's shoes definitely paid off with the ungating. Loved it. They didn't have hardly any men's shoes at Macy's. I feel so bad for dudes sometimes because they just don't have as much variety as us chicks do. Oh, and you guys don't really have anything glittery. Sounds horrible. I'm sorry. It's discrimination. So after the shoes, I found this like clearance area, and that is where I scored. I got a household item. I paid $29.96 for it. It sells for $78.95, and I should profit $22.71 on each of those, and I wound up getting all four of them that I could find. So $88 in profit for those four items. I checked Keepa, I checked IP Alert, like I did my research before I bought them. The only thing that makes me a wee bit nervous is because this was a Macy's last chance deal, which I don't know anything about Macy's and their last chance deals, but from what I understand, the lady told me I cannot return it. So keep that in mind if you buy their clearance last chance, but hopefully I won't need to return it because the rank is really low. Amazon's not selling on it and it has a good history of selling. So I think these will be okay. Then I went over to the kitchen gadget area. They have some shelves and nooks and crannies here and there that have clearance stuff, and I scanned a bunch of that. I came really close on some cookie cutters that I found, but I wound up not getting them. And then I kind of started looking around and I noticed that I didn't see any Nike stuff. I did see Under Armour and Adidas and Hurley, but I guess Macy's doesn't carry Nike here. Maybe they carry it online. I don't know. So I kind of just didn't even bother scanning clothes after I realized there weren't any Nike clothes. And then my last stop was at Toys, and they had a lot of Melissa and Doug toys, which I am engaged in Melissa and Doug, but I haven't really bought any Melissa and Doug. The one time I bought Melissa and Doug online, when they sent it to my house, they didn't put it in a box. They just slapped a label on it and sent it off in the mail. So by the time it got to me, it looked like it fell off the delivery truck and tumbled down the road and landed in poop. That's what it looked like. It was awful. So I returned them, but I will say I'm kind of wanting to go to Macy's.com and source for clearance Melissa and Doug on their website maybe. I don't know. It's an idea. It's brewing in there. So if you're ungated in Melissa and Doug, FYI, Macy's carries a lot of it. They also had Barbies and Hot Wheels and all sorts of toys. I looked through a lot of the toys, wasn't really finding any profitable items. So that's when I decided to take my $88 profit and leave. Oh, another fun fact about Macy's is they don't have like buggies or scooters or baskets. You have to carry everything or go put it at the register on hold. So I learned that today. It was just a good learning experience. It's weird because shopping at unfamiliar stores is fun because you learn about the stores and the potential and hidden treasures, but it also takes time, but it's worth it. My milkshake melted, ew. I think I'm gonna call it a day for today. Today was just gonna be a quick trip. I'm gonna take my goodies and go home into the air conditioner. I still have to like pack and prep all my stuff from earlier this week, so I'll probably get into that. Today was fun. If there's like a store you haven't been to in a while or a store you want to go check out, this is your sign. I am your sign. Go out there, check out that store you haven't checked out in a while. Go to that store you've been wanting to go to. I got everything packed up from Macy's and it all fit in one large box. Just a little recap, I bought four items from Macy's, each one of them profits $22.71 for a total potential profit of $90.84, which wasn't too bad because I was only in Macy's for about an hour and I really only sourced for about an hour and a half that day. Thank you so much for watching. Thank you so much for hanging out with me today while I went on this quick trip outsourcing. Oh, and let me know if you go try the churro shake or the pickle slushy. I want your thoughts on those below. Please like and subscribe and comment, and I will see you next time. Bye.